Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Thursday of the 33rd week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. The Lord said, I think thoughts of peace and not of affliction. You will call upon me and I will answer you. And I will lead back your captives from every place.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you. For it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a scroll in the right hand of the one who sat on the throne. It had writing on both sides and was sealed with seven seals. Then I saw a mighty angel who proclaimed in a loud voice, "Who is worthy to open the scroll and break its seals?" But no one in heaven or on earth or under the earth was able to open the scroll or to examine it. I shed many tears because no one was found worthy to open the scroll or to examine it. One of the elders said to me, "Do not weep. The Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, has triumphed, enabling him to open the scroll with its seven seals." Then I saw standing in the midst of the throne and the four living creatures and the elders a lamb that seemed to have been slain. He had seven horns and seven eyes. These are the seven spirits of God sent out into the whole world. He came and received the scroll from the right hand of the one who sat on the throne. When he took it, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb. Each of the elders held a harp and a gold bowl and gold bowls filled with incense, which are the prayers of the holy ones. They sang a new hymn. "Worthy are you to receive the scroll and break open its seals, for you were slain, and with your blood you purchased for God those from every tribe and tongue, people and nation. You made them a kingdom and priests for our God, and they will reign on earth." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, "The Lamb has made us a kingdom of priests to serve our God."
The Lamb has made us a kingdom of priests to serve our God.
Sing to the Lord a new song of praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel be glad in their Maker. Let the children of Zion rejoice in their King.
The Lamb has made us a kingdom of priests to serve our God.
Let them praise His name in the festive dance. Let them sing praise to Him with timbrel and harp. For the Lord loves His people, and He adorns the lowly with victory.
The Lamb has made us a kingdom of priests to serve our God.
Let the faithful exult in glory. Let them sing for joy upon their couches. Let the high praises of God be in their throats. This is the glory of all His faithful. Alleluia.
The Lamb has made us a kingdom of priests to serve our God. Alleluia, alleluia. If today you hear His voice, harden not your hearts. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus drew near Jerusalem, he saw the city and wept over it, saying, "If this day you only knew what makes for peace, but now it is hidden from your eyes. For the days are coming upon you when your enemies will raise a palisade against you. They will encircle you and hem you in on all sides. They will smash you to the ground and your children within you. And they will not leave one stone upon another within you because you did not recognize the time of your visitation." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, today and tomorrow, you have actually, you know, almost like a same unit, no, of the Gospel. No? And it's very interesting because in these two parts of the narrative, Jesus here really, you know, bears out his pain and agony, his lament over Jerusalem. We need to remember that in that first century, Jerusalem will be destroyed. No? And here you have Christ, sort of, there's a prophecy, no, that Christ gives. And then tomorrow, the gospel, which is a continuation of this passage, will talk about the cleansing in the temple. Of course, we read that a couple of weeks back, no, during the feast of the dedication of the Lateran Basilica. Of course, we read the one in the version of, I think, Saint Matthew or Luke. But the cleansing, a more detailed account of the cleansing in the temple. And here you have Christ really expressing his sorrow why Jerusalem did not choose the way of God. And I think the key for our reflection today is the very end of the gospel, wherein the Lord says, "Because you did not recognize the time of your visitation." And here, I think, is a very good lesson for us, no? Of course, diba, earlier during this pandemic, there's this whole discussion if this is the punishment of God, the suffering that we are going through, the pandemic, no? And remember what I shared with you, the Australian Jesuit who wrote that, no, God did not wish this pandemic on us, but the suffering that will happen or that is happening is because of the choices that we made along the way of this pandemic, the wrong choices that leaders made, the wrong choices that governments made. So that is what brought about the suffering. And I think basically that is the message of today's gospel. Diba nung una, yun yung ating pinagninilayan. Yung sinasabi nga natin na ito ba ay parusa ng Diyos, itong pandemya, no? At sinasabi ko, hindi, ang Diyos, hindi, ang pandemya ay isang sabihin namin natin, kababalaghan ng siyensa, ng kalikasan, ano? Na nag-mutate yung virus, at isang virus na bago at mahirap gamutin, na wala pa tayong nalalamang gamot, wala pang bakuna laban sa kanya. Hindi yun yung parusa ng Diyos, kundi ang nangyayaring pagdurusa ay dahil sa mga maling pagpili na ginawa ng mga pinuno, ng mga gobyerno. At yun ang sinasabi ng Panginoon ngayon sa ating Ebanghelyo. Because you did not recognize the time of your visitation. That here you have the Lord sending the Messiah, sending the Savior of the world, and Christ preaching that the way to salvation is the way of service, of emptying oneself, and ultimately the way of the cross. And yet people rejected that. They did not recognize the time of their visitation. At marami rin tayo rin mga ganoong, masasabi natin pagkukulang, na hindi natin nakikita ang presensya ng Diyos sa ating mga buhay, ang panawagan ng Diyos na magbalik loob sa Kanya, ang panawagan ng Diyos na isa-isang tabi natin yung mga masasamang pamamaraan, di ba, ang korupsyon sa gobyerno, di ba, itong mga nakaraang buwan lang, di ba, so, yung corruption sa PhilHealth. And yet, no, dahil sa hindi tayo tumutugon sa tawag ng Diyos sa atin na magbalik loob, yun ang nagdadala ng ating kaparusahan, kung gusto ninyo, no? I think that is something that we need to reflect on, no? Because it's very, very close to what we're experiencing. The Lord was condemning how the Jewish leaders were really, in a sense, politicizing, no? And that brought about the destruction of Jerusalem, I think, in 70 AD. And the Lord is saying that, no, because you did not recognize God offering you the way of the cross, the way of salvation, and yet people chose to stick to their corrupt ways. People chose to stick that politicizing, which eventually brought the ruin of Jerusalem. Siguro mahalaga na pagnilaya natin ngayon yan, na sa panahon ng matinding pagdurusa, sa panahon ng matinding, hindi lamang sa pandemya, kundi ang mga nakaraang na sakuna or kalamidad sa ating bayan, si Rolly, si Ulysses, yung bahang nangyari sa Norte, sa Isabela at sa Cagayan Valley, dahil ito ay sa mga pagkukulang natin, hindi ito parusa ng Diyos, kundi pagkukulang natin sa ating pag-aalaga sa isa't isa, pag-aalaga sa kalikasan, at kahit yung paghahanda, no, para sa mga dumating na bagyo. And perhaps we should do a serious soul searching. I think if what has happened to us the last week, almost 2 weeks, calls us to a serious soul searching. And recently, the government that launched that anti-hunger laban sa gutom drive. And let us pray that it may be a genuine effort to help our people. And not only should we launch all of these efforts, but I think we need to repent and magbalik loob. I think it's time to seriously look at our collective conscience as a people. What is that conscience collective that will tell us now what is right? Because ultimately, it is that conscience collective as a people that will guide us in making the right choices. Sama-sama bilang isang bansa, isang mga kapwa Pilipino, piliin natin ang tamang daan. Piliin natin ang tamang daan na magbabawas ng pagdurusa ng ating mga kababayan. Today, let us seriously pray over this gospel. And I pray that you may take to heart the word of the Lord. You did not recognize the time of your visitation. Let us pray that we will recognize the Lord's message and the Lord's visitation now in our midst. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us make our prayers of intercession as part of our pilgrimage of faith, following Christ to the eternal Jerusalem, our promised inheritance. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may become a living sign and instrument of unity and peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as a community of believers, we may not be divided by petty barriers of hatred and prejudice, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may avoid making excuses in responding to the demands of our faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That life's misfortunes or sickness may not distract us from our resolve to follow Jesus, especially during this time in the pandemic, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That eternal salvation be given to the faithful departed, and especially those who have died due to the virus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us now also offer our prayers for the souls of the faithful departed, especially those commended to our prayers. The souls of the faithful departed we wish to remember in all the ABS-CBN Masses. We pray too for the souls in purgatory, and we pray for the eternal repose of the souls of our relatives and friends. So together let us offer this prayer for the faithful departed.
Prayer for the faithful departed. This month of all souls, we remember all our family and friends who have gone ahead of us. We pray for all the souls in purgatory. Grant them, Father, eternal rest together with you, with our risen Lord, with the Spirit of Life, with our Blessed Mother, and with all the saints. May we always remember them in our prayers. We ask that they too pray for us, all our family and friends who continue our journey here on earth. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your Majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love we celebrate His death. With living faith, we proclaim His resurrection. With unwavering hope, we await His return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Ernesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. We remember especially all the souls of the faithful departed, commended to our prayers, commended to our intentions in our masses. We pray too for all the souls in purgatory. And we remember our departed relatives and friends. Let us now pause for a moment and remember our departed relatives and friends. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Together, let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people, tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem the tide of its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us.
And let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.